Hello friends, my name is Atul and you're watching Techobia. In today's video, I'm going to give you the walkthrough of Dlink DSL 224 modem and the router provided by the Airtel for their VDSL connections, show you the speed test, how you can configure it for the dynamic IP, how you can configure it for the static IP, how we can check the status, how you can hide your Wi-Fi over the LAN, how you can set up the forward forwarding, how you can configure it for your DVR cameras, how you can hard reset it. Everything in the single video. So stay tuned and enjoy. That this modems come with this type of the interface with two dual antennas, and as normal like the other modems, it has a WPS and the 4 LAN configuration, whereas it is missing the USB port like the Huawei SG630A. And the main thing is power switch on and off button is on the back, which seems like a little weird to me, because if it should be on the side, that would be the like best position to place it. But if you are looking at the back, you can see like these two holes, like to hang it on the wall, it is very easy in this modem, whereas in the previous modem like SG630A, which I can say is still a best modem. Why it is best, I am planning to like make a new video in which I will compare all these four modems for you. As in this, it is an adapter, like you see, like this adapter is coming with it. It is a very small adapter. Continue to the outlook, it also has a sort of a rubber placement on the bottom, as D-Link is like maintaining its standard, and it also has a wall mount with the dual antenna, whereas all the functionality buttons are on the back and the lighting is on the front, and the all the lights in green. So this is the hardware structure of the modem. So let's switch to the setting. What you need to do, you need to open your interface. So first you can access your interface using its default IP, which is also available on the bottom, which includes username and password and the other information like the serial number and so on. And again, the thing is, firmware of this modem is also customized by the Airtel. So if you just own it for the first time, the default name is Airtel Zero Touch in your Wi-Fi, and again the password is Airtel 123. So when you just come here, you need to click on the setup. There you need to go to the internet setup. There you can see there are some options, like 5 options in the bottom in the current WAN table. I suggest you to delete all those. And if you are planning to add it for the static IP, so start first with the static IP. In the channel type, you need to select PTM, and in the channel mode you can see this option DHCP static. This is specially mentioned like this. Just click on it. And for the 802.1Q, you need to click on enable and make sure that in the VLAN ID, enter 100. This is must. I was like ignoring this option previously, and I was not able to get the access to the internet. Then after that, you can see like the PPA settings are automatically read-only for you. And in the WAN IP settings, you need to insert your static IP, local IP address, which is assigned to you. Like in my case, it's 122.222. Not going to reveal it. And definitely in the remote IP, you need to use the same IP, but the last digit is with the 1. Netmask, same 255.255.255.0. And then you just only need to simple click on the add. Once it's added, you are not done here, because sometimes something wrong is going on. It is not going to pick up the DNS automatically. Suggest you to configure the DNS manually. So you can click on the wireless setup, and there you can see this DNS option, and there in the DNS you can insert the Google DNS as well, which are 8.8.8.8, and the secondary is 8.8.4.4. So now if I'm checking, yes, the Google is working fine for me. So now it's the time I can show you that how you can set it for your normal IP. The procedure is same. You need to log into your account using 192.168.1.1, and there again click on internet setup, then channel settings. There again, I suggest you, even you can edit this option. If you click on that, you are able to like make the changes in the same option, or you can remove it, delete it, and then just adding it once again. In the channel type, you need to select the PTM, and channel mode is PPPoE. Again, as same as the static IP for the 802, you need to enable it and the VLAN set to the 100. And after that, IP protocol is IPv4. Here in the PPP settings, enter your username, which is your DSL ID, like mine is 017216 and xxx_dsl@airtelbroadband.in. And the password, in most of the cases, your account number is your password. And nothing you have to modify after that. Just click on add. And again, make sure that in the DNS, you have manual settings inserted for your DNS. Then we can check here, site is working. Again, we are okay. So let's do one speed test for the speed. So here I'm like running a speed test for you. So you can see that how much speed I am getting at the 40 Mbps connection, where the speed provided to me is 40 Mbps for the download and upload, there is no commitment. And the quota which I am getting per month is 65 GB. So here we can see like for the download, we are getting almost 40 Mbps. And for the upload, it shows us like 9 Mbps plus. Like it always varies between 6 to 9. But 9 is good, as you know that I'm using two connections. For my another connection, I never like get more than 6 Mbps in that connection. So it depends on area to area or port to port. I'm not sure that what's the reason. So let's proceed toward the port forwarding, or if you want to configure your DVR camera on that. Again, you need to go to the interface, click on advanced. There you can see this option, port forwarding. Then click on that. Like if you are just trying to set the port for some common service, you can directly set the usual service name and it will automatically fill the ports for you. Like if you are not, you can even set your own custom name from the user defined service name. Like I'm like setting it for the FTP currently. So WAN is not our case. So what we are doing, like we are on a static IP, and what we want, like if someone is accessing 21 port from the outside world, it will get the access to the 21 port, but on that particular local IP where our server is configured. Like if we are using some Linux machine and OpenSSH is configured over there, and that machine has static IP on the LAN is 192.168.1.5. So it will automatically redirect that particular FTP user to that particular machine if the request comes for 21 port. Like in the same way, if we have to configure it for our DVR camera, like normally the DVR cameras are configured on the HTTP 80 port, which I never suggest to set it for the 80 port, because most of the time we need 80 port for the other server. So what I normally use, I set the WAN port to 8080 or some other port like 801 and set the LAN open port to 80, whereas I'm going to set the LAN IP address to my camera IP, which is 192.168.1.160. So here we are done with the port forwarding. And if you want to do the reset, again the option is in the maintenance, and then in the maintenance you need to click on the reset settings. How to hide your wireless modem on the wireless thing. So how we can do that? For that you need to access your interface once again. You need to click on the setup, then in the wireless setup, go to click on the wireless setup. There you can see this channel, there is no option available like if you want to hide your internet. So the question is like from where we are going to hide it. So simple, in the wireless setup you need to click on the wireless security. And if we click on the wireless security, we have multiple options. In the case if you want to change the password, you can change the password from here. And even you can see the available password, which is airtel@123, which is normally configured for Airtel Zero Touch devices coming with the pre-loaded firmware from the Airtel. Then as to hide, we need to click on the advanced, and when we click on the advanced wireless, there you can see this option, broadcast SSID. We just only need to click on the disabled and apply changes. In that case, right now your wireless is hidden for the devices in your range. You just only need to configure it manually or need to set it as a hidden network. So as I'm looking at the status currently right now, it is showing me that I'm using a DSL 224 modem and the firmware version is 80.1.11, which was last updated on June 12 of the 2017 build date. So it is the up-to-date firmware. And according to the current information from the Airtel technicians, which I came to know, right now there is no manual firmware provided to us or to the technicians to update your modems. If your CWMP or Tr069, what are these? If you want to know, you can check the link in the cards. You need to enable that. If these are enabled, what the Airtel will do when your system is connected, it will automatically update your firmware to the latest release automatically. And if you are a little concerned about the security like me and you don't want like someone to provide the access to your modem, you can disable Tr069. So from here you can check the status. As you can see, like the status is up. And you can see like the upstream speed, which is available up to the 10 Mbps, and the down speed, it is showing me like up to 65 Mbps, where I was getting the 40 Mbps. And this is a status which I'm showing you. It was in my office when I was connected to the static IP. When I was at the home, like downstream speed like shown to me was around 48,000 kbps. So I hope so that I provided you the enough information so you will have the enough walkthrough about this modem. But still, if you have any queries or if you are using this modem and other modems, if you are facing any problem, if you need any type of the solution, please tell me in the comments. I would love to answer your questions. So guys, I hope you love and you enjoyed this video. So please give it a thumbs up if you like this video and sub to show your love. See you soon in the upcoming video. Signing off for today. Bye bye.